Hi, I'm Carlos Diaz, Library Associate at St. John the Baptist Parish Library, and this is a book talk. Today's book talk is going to be a little bit different. Since April is National Poetry Month, I thought I'd read some poetry to you and see what you guys think about it. I'm reading two poems. One is an 1873 nursery rhyme, which was from the 19th century, about a popular TV show now. And another one is a classic that I really enjoyed reading when I took a literature class in college. So the first one goes a little something like this. Please bear with me. 1873 nursery rhyme. Monday's child is fair of face. Tuesday's child is full of grace. Wednesday's child is full of woe. Thursday's child has far to go. Friday's child is loving and giving. Saturday's child works hard for a living. But the child that is born on the Sabbath day is bonny and blithe, good and gay. And what we have here, I want to focus on Wednesday's child is full of woe. And I want to talk about Wednesday Adams, who is one of the titular characters in a popular TV show titled Wednesday. Of course, the character is also from the Adams family, which was a very popular films in the early 90s and a popular TV show in the 60s. And everyone loves Wednesday Adams. They just like her her mischief character, her way of being, her nature. She's very tricky. She's mischievous. And people can relate to that. There's also goodness in her, even though she comes across as a very mischievous or imp type of child, if you will. People always gravitate toward her, and people will always find her character very endearing. It's very popular. So I thought it was very interesting to read this type of a poem. It's very quick. It's readily available with a standard Google search. But I'll also leave a link on this video so you guys can easily upload it to your devices and read it as you will. All right, transitioning real quickly, the next poem is To His Coy Mistress. It was published in the 17th century in 1681, posthumously after Andrew Marvell's death. I'm not going to read the whole poem to you because it's considerably long. But I'll read the first stanza, and I'll read the last one, and then we'll discuss it. Had we but whirled enough in time, this coyness, lady, were no crime. We would sit down and think which way to walk and pass along love's day. Thus, by the Indian Ganges side, shouldn't rubies find, I by the tide of Humber would complain, I would love you 10 years before the flood, and you should, if you please, refuse to the conversion of the Jews. Moving on to the final stanza. And now, like amorous birds of prey, rather at once our time devour than languish in this slow chapped power, let us roll all of our strength and our sweetness into a one ball and tear our pleasures with rough strife through the iron gates of life. Thus, though we cannot make our son stand still, yet we will make him run. I read this poem when I was in college. It was for an interpreting literature class, and I'm not big on poetry as I am with prose. Poetry is very difficult for me to understand. Prose comes a lot easier. But this poem, it's very cool. I like it because it's very graphic in nature, but it talks about longing. It talks about time. And those are two subjects that are universal. Those are two things that we can relate to. Longing is like feeling pain, you wanting something, you yearn for something, and yet you can't have it. And then time, it's one of those things that you can't capture, you can only manage. And I think that's what this poem is about, His Coy Mistress. It's beautiful. The language is quite vivid. It really connotes a lot of imagery. There's a lot of history. There's a little politics in there. But I thoroughly enjoyed it. Again, I'll put a link on this video so you guys can read it for yourselves and let me know what you think about it. And then do that. You know, get out of your comfort zone, read some poetry, something that you find interesting. There's beautiful works out there. So during this month, I encourage you to enjoy some poetry, whether it's classic or contemporary. You should definitely do that. So thank you for your time. This is Carlos Diaz, and this is a book talk. Thank you.